How's it going, guys? This is Coleman from C&J Outdoors. Yesterday we did some time lapses and stuff. I'm not sure how the wife's going to edit this all together, but kind of to go over what we did yesterday on the time lapses on the chicken coop build. This is one finished product. We got to build the other half still. We're going to be doing that today. You'll probably see some time lapses. We went with gray barn steel on the outside, charcoal gray around the front side. This is going to be our chicken door here. It is elevated underneath so they can have more run space. So I'll have a ramp in here. This will all be enclosed. You'll see the finished product once I'm done. We can go around to the inside here. Doors with lockable latches. On the inside here, this is going to be the hen house. There is two full-length perches. Give them an area to perch. And we do have 6 egg boxes so the egg-laying hens can get in there. The way I designed this is so down here, you see there's no floor in this chicken coop. Right here, there's a 2-inch slot. A good buddy of mine is making me 2-inch aluminum trays with handles so I can slide them in there and slide them right out. So that way I can clean the bedding out and just power wash the trays out, have everything all nice and clean, slide it back in, and I'm good to go. This coop is going to be 20 foot in total length, which means from here all the way to the back side of the other coop is going to be 20 feet. These are 3 foot wide by 6 foot long, and then my run is going to attach here, and that will be 7 foot long each piece, each panel that I build, by 6 foot wide, also 6 foot tall, so I'll be able to get in there with barely having to bend down. I added clear up here, give my houses some light for the egg laying hens. I was told that they wouldn't lay in the dark, so they should have plenty of light. This is approximately 1 foot of light for 6 foot long, so that should be plenty of sunlight to come in. The roof, we did do a 3-inch overhang, make sure the water doesn't go in, and this is approximately a 20 degree slope. So it should be no problem shedding water or snow. So that's a little catch me up on what we've been doing. All the time lapses you've seen. Should look good when I'm done. We're going to try to finish the other one today and see if we can't get all the panels and stuff done today too. The other one is over here. I've been trying to do most of the work in the garage so that way I haven't been able to have to be out in the cold. It is still getting pretty cold here at night, and the mornings have been chilly. But this weekend's been really good. So this is the same concept. It's going to be 2 doors on the back. This is going to be on the meat chicken end of this coop. So there is no hen boxes, as you can see, but there is 3 perches because I do plan on having a few more meat chickens than I'm going to have egg layers. So there's 3 perches in this one. We do have most of the steel cut. We're going to try to get this put together today. You will see some time lapses here shortly. So stay tuned, guys, for more. New to the whole YouTube thing, so bear with me. If you guys have any questions about anything that we've done under the time lapses, feel free to drop us a comment down below and ask any questions. I am not a professional carpenter by any means, but I get by. I do pretty good. Anything I can help you guys with, I'd be more than happy to. Stay tuned, guys.
You don't want to come out, but you don't want to be alone. It don't take but two to have a little soiree. If you're in the mood, sit down right where you are, baby. Cause I need a
as you guys may have seen bouncing in and out of the garage and some of the time lapses and some of our other videos, these are the dogs. Rona, come here. Sit down. This is Missy. She is an English Springer Spaniel. She is just a hair over a year old. So she's my pheasant and upland bird dog. She's doing pretty good. She's been out a couple times and got herself a few pheasants. She's a very, very interested, very hyperactive dog. Always wants to play fetch. Always has to have a stick or a ball in her mouth. This is our newest member. Come here, Rona. Sit down, miss. Stay. Stay. Sit down, Rona. Sit, Rona. Sit, Rona. Good girl. This is the newest member of our family. This is a purebred black lab. She is approximately 15 weeks old. She's doing really good so far. Seems to be smart. Seems to be listening pretty good. This is going to be my duck dog. I needed a dog with the double layer fur for all the colder weather we have in the fall trying to duck hunt. My Springer Spaniel loves to go, but getting in that colder water or any sort of ice, she doesn't have enough fur. She gets cold. So these are my two hunting dogs. I'm sure you'll see them bouncing around through all of our videos. Enjoy.